And is nice.
Look at his worst placing.
His ag score is 173. That's off the charts.
It's out of control. He is, you know, and he's got the product in his hair, all that. He's ready to go.
You think that's an intentional? Do you think the product's in there? And that one hair swoops right in front of his face on purpose?
He spent a good 15 minutes getting it like that.
I actually believe you. Not sure if I should.
As we do in the mirror sometimes in the morning. Again, it's like he's cold, but he's not. He's not sure what he wants to do with this hoodie here, but he fist bumps.
I think that means we're going to Fountain of Dreams. Game one, Zane versus Esfat, and Esfat got here after beating Plup, yeah?
Yes, he did. It was a mixed bag of emotion, I think, for everyone. Plup now Mega Man main.
So many bags of emotion in Melee. Wow, clean first stock slime.
Let's go. It looked pretty bad too, because Zane got like the off rip 1 second grab and then couldn't make it happen the way Zane does and then gets shined anyway. Down tilts.
Winner will be in top 8 winner side.
Insane. Let's go.
The loser
is gonna have to
go down into the shark pit.
The shark pit with
this
H-box.
Loser's bracket. H-box and Plup down there. Ooh, that is difficult to time slime. Have you tried to hit with Tipper Forward Smash from a fox coming down like that?
It is, dude.
I think that's like borderline impossible.
Because he can move. He moves like
he
a
can move left and right.
Little
he can,
aerial boy.
He can fall down faster.
It's really tough. It's I think the Falcon equivalent is hitting the knee without getting burned. Also hard.
Got some weirdness going on, but Zane is always gonna get that.
Back and forth, yeah. I love Esfat because game one, Esfat goes right to the ledge and starts shining around when Zane's, you know, trying to wait out invincibility. I feel like game five, Esfat doesn't do that, and it's fun to see the progression of risk taking.
Yeah,
and kind of getting
that
your system.
But Esfat making it really hard for Zane to get back. Zane's even used forward air there to try to like get Esfat off the ledge. Zach knew that he had the invincibility and then reacted with a shine.
He's getting a lot of down tilt too. It's the tool to keep the box honest, and it's happening. Oh my god. Where
you going? You like neutral B?
Oh yeah, it's purple.
I like it. I like it there for sure. That was a really creative one. You like anything purple?
Yeah, dude.
What about Ganondorf? You like Ganondorf?
I love Ganondorf, dude.
I didn't know that. I love Ganondorf too.
He's strong. Up throw, misses. Reads a heck left.
Wow, that forward smash was actually so sick. Reading the spot dodge and like, I guess I feel like most of the time you want to dash in and grab when you have that read, but forward smash will do it.
Yeah, definitely.
I feel like not for a ton of characters is that like a good idea, but for Marth with his crazy range.
He also plays for the edge guard. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, he's safe. I'm surprised he didn't get tipped there. Esfat might be dead.
Oh my god. Oh, he's gonna do stuff.
That was actually so sick.
He did the stuff.
If you really like what I love about Zane is that, you know, he gets that forward smash and Esfat's clearly not dead. And every move that he did, like, you know how Axe controls the teeny tiny hitboxes of up air to like get to continue a combo? Because
right.
There's like a bunch. Marth has a bunch of different hitboxes on his moves too, and I feel like Zane did both of those up airs to get that grab to set up for that reverse forward air down air. It's like he has that idea in his head the whole time.
Way in advance.
Like I can see that, you know, he had that all planned out.
And, well, I think
and probably some other contingencies, right, if Esfat DIs differently.
Yeah. Oh,
owie!
Just like that.
Ouch!
I think the best feeling in Melee is having a plan and then it follows through.
Oh yeah, it's so sick.
And Zane is, I think, one of the... Oh, here we go. Nice.
Yeah. Not gonna make it back. Esfat answering back.
Zane will do that. We're on the whole train.
It does feel like... For some reason, it feels like Zane's whooping Esfat, but it is really close. I guess it just feels like Marth hurts Fox more. I feel like I feel Fox losing stocks more.
Yeah, for sure. Oh my god.
Double down tilt.
Nice. So, okay. I'll burn a little bit. That was really creative, though.
A little risky. I was worried about Zane getting pineappled.
Yeah.
Going.
You can always go too low.
Yeah. Okay.
It's, Oh,
I like that. Wow, just barely living.
This is your pick. This is what Fox wants. This is the future you want. All right, a little shine for a good measure.
Yeah.
What was I going to say about Zayn and Mark? Dude, he uses so many aerials, actually. Like, we just watched Muta King versus IDW.
That was so sick.
It's just like, he's a different animal. Obviously, Zayn. Like, whenever every Mark gets the grab and they turn into, like, the collective Mark, right? The idea. But before that,
the idea.
He's nairing three times in a row in place and just, like, I don't know. That's not too out of the ordinary, but it's like, damn, he's going for it.
Yeah, he's definitely going for it.
He likes to rip it.
He's definitely going for it. I'm definitely in love with Zayn's combos, so that's what I'm mostly focusing on. What he did before to take the last stock was one of those Captain Falcon down airs that pops him up after they've missed the tech into another down air to kill S-Fat.
Yeah.
But S-Fat with a lead here.
Nice. God, slide-off. Reading slide-off is the next level, and then reading the read of the slide-off is where we come around again. Again,
how long is it
going
to take for us to get there?
Oh, like one set. The next Fox Marsh.
The next one.
Ooh!
Called him.
Back-to-back two stocks.
I like it.
Oh, and a set boy. Count of 1-1.
Where is he? Zach didn't take him to FD in game one, so we're going there now. Doesn't like doing that anymore.
Yeah.
Doesn't work out as well.
S-Fat's, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he used to. I don't know how long that lasted, but
it was a phase. It was like he was going through some stuff. Like he bought a motorcycle, he had a ponytail. Like it was a bad spot in his life.
Yeah.
But he's through it now.
He now thinks that this is not a great stage.
Yeah.
Versus Marth.
And now he doesn't choose this.
At least he doesn't. Yeah, choose it.
There's always.
Yeah, I saw
element,
that one
so.
Tweet where it was like, "Oh, Fox beats Marth in FD." I was like, "Oh, all right."
Damn, that's crazy.
I remember asking some other foxes, like Toph, like, is this a fox thing or is this an S-Fat thing? They were like, dude, this is an S-Fat thing.
we do not represent.
Yeah. S-Fat is not representative of our views.
Oh, the double! Lucky did that the other day against a Marth player in pools, and it was really, really cute. S-Fat did the level two, which is two shine stalls, and then Zayn beat that. Nice tech.
That was actually so sick by S-Fat to hitting the down tilt and then kind of reacting and just getting those little hits to keep Zayn recovering.
Yeah.
That was, like, pretty dope.
Like, it also, anticipating, I mean, you got to be ready no matter what, but, like, who techs a down tilt, right? And then Zayn having the presence
ready
of mind.
For it, yeah.
Shield that. Never get hit by the lasers like that. Ever. Stay winning.
That's about looking really good.
Yeah. So, yeah, so a lot
keeping
of,
is cool.
It's a lot of, like, nair and fair counterplay. Like, and the down tilt is when Zayn typically just goes in, right? He'll approach with a down tilt. Oh, my God. Here we go. Oh.
80, 90.
Go there.
Yeah, I don't think S-Fat had a jump. I think he lost it in that juggle.
But
go if, there.
If he feels like S-Fat's going to come through with that with the toolie. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Come on.
S-Fat went too far down. Well, he's kind of screwed there, Slime.
Yeah.
If S-Fat doesn't go so far down, Zayn is going to up-B him. And then he's going to die.
It's so hard, dude.
And so I feel like in that moment, S-Fat kind of asked Zayn, like, are you going to be able to react quickly enough to me dropping down too low for you to up-B me and then grab the ledge? But then Zayn has to sweet spot it, you know what I mean?
Yep.
So I feel like it was legit.
Here we go. Nice grab. All the way. S-Fat gets a second chance, unfortunately gets CC grabbed. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Doesn't crouch cancel break your heart sometimes?
Sometimes,
like,
dude.
You know what I mean?
I was watching. Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, he just fought out of that one situation. He gets a hit. It's like, oh, everything's coming my way. And then it's just like, oh.
I was watching Zamu against another Sheik player who was actually really good in pools yesterday. And Zamu was like, he had this chart in his head. I can crouch cancel up smash at this percent and this percent up to only. And it was egregious. It was like, how dare he? It's like 56%. He just stands still, getting hit in the face by Sheik.
And up smashing.
And it's like, that's how it goes.
It can hurt, man. That is a, speaking of emotional roller coasters.
Oh,
that was almost a sick low percent conversion by S-Fat.
Oh.
Catching his feet. Foss can run up down tilt too.
Yeah, he's also got that one.
Like, I got that. Oh,
nice. He's alive.
Living, yeah.
For a little bit.
Yeah.
Purple
now.
Stuff. Not gonna happen. Okay.
Just got swatted away. I like SFAT, you know, putting the pressure on offstage. But, you know, Zane was reacting. He's paying attention.
Yeah, it's like,
too easy in those situations. Uh-oh, that was not good by SFAT. SFAT just kind of got lazy with his sweet spot. Oh, yes. Did he get an invisible ceiling? He just fell.
Oh, my God.
That forward air, he went straight down. It's like the weirdest angle.
Yeah, that was okay. Last hit of Dare, the new wave. Nice.
Oh, I like the idea by SFAT. But he's got a mountain to climb right now. SFAT's chances of winning are going down the drain.
Just an easy dunk.
That was sick.
Easy dunk.
Is that an easy dunk?
Yeah.
I think that one's kind of hard.
I mean, I guess
that was dope.
The way Melee's hard.
Yeah. But okay, like, yeah, you're right. If you're Zane, that's an easy dunk. Whew. That's an up throw down air. I've done that a million times.
Nice. Get down there. No! Yeah. Get up there!
Oh. Worked out for SFAT that time.
Okay.
He's got the faintest glimmer of a chance.
Damn, a lot of power shields coming out, too. Zane's counterplay is just too strong right now. Like, every idea that SFAT has during a punish or during an edge guard, or I think neutral, they're, like, fairly even. But, like, he just has the answer, and you gotta... I don't know.
Do you know how SFAT's feeling right now, Slime?
Probably really confident. I can do this.
No, this is a moment. I had a moment like this earlier playing against Sam Park, where I was down by this much, and it's like, you just know... It's go time or go home time. It's a very specific feeling.
And then you
get he felt it and he lost.
Ledge.
Most of the time that you feel that feeling where it's like either everything's coming together now or I'm going to lose, you lose.
Yeah, right?
But sometimes it comes together.
What's the percentage of coming together?
Versus a player like Zane?
Yeah. What is his odds before he gets knocked
off stage? Versus a player like Zane, it's not good. I've experienced being in that situation versus players who are not of Zane's caliber. And so I can give you my percentage.
Please.
It's maybe like 10.
I was going to say a hot 10.
One in 10 times I actually make it happen and bring it back 3-1, go into game 5 and win.
They have to make so many mistakes. They have to be worse than you at that point. And it's like, oh, man.
Or you just play transcendently. You take their skill and you turn it upside down where it's like all of your advantage now becomes your disadvantage. You walk into your own hell. That can happen.
How's that happen to you? Describe what that's like. Entering that state.
You just are no longer fully conscious, I swear to God. You're like not even really thinking anymore. It's like because you know that thinking is the path to losing. Because you've been thinking this whole way.
It hasn't worked so
far.
And
so you just like don't do everything that you want to do in some weird way. And it like starts working and then it starts snowballing.
You just unlock the heart.
You know Sam Park, the guy that Blur had to draw?
No.
Blur did a money match. Well, there's a gentleman, Sam Park. He money matches people. A drawing portrait money match. The loser has to draw the winner.
Oh, I see. Okay.
He's done this with many top players. He's drawn many beautiful portraits. Mm. He challenged Blur some time ago, and he won.
Okay.
So Blur had to draw Sam Park, which is not the intent of the money match, right? The intent is I'll challenge these famous players and, like, draw them.
Yes, of course.
Well, either he's gotten a lot better or he was always really good, but he challenged me yesterday. And I swear to God, I was a 1-4 smash away from drawing Sam Park's face. But it all turned around. I don't know how it happened.
So that means he has a... does he draw the players?
Good. Yeah, he has to draw me now.
Oh, I see.
So I was down a game, and he had 3 stocks to my one.
What character
did you play? I was Falcon Marth.
Okay, yeah.
Every time he hit me, I died. I had to change my whole mindset to realize that if I get hit by this man, I will die. And then, so it's like, it just becomes clear you could, like, just literally can't get hit.
It is clear, right? Like, you just
can't get hit.
Run away.
If I get hit, I lose.